you know, it's October, so a lot of people wearing pink. And you heard me talking about this last week. You know, I don't wear pink in October because I you know, just looking at a lot of the research in terms of what's actually killing people. And what's happening is you've got this, what some are now coming out and calling the pink distraction, you know, in terms of distracting attention away from real solutions. And there's a lot of money to be made out there. There's a lot of profit being made. And when it comes to breast cancer, you've still got essentially the same number of women dying every year and men. You're talking about close to 40,000 people. It's a lot. It's a lot. It's too many. And that number's been stagnant. Really, it's been flat for the last 25 years. So all of the publicity and the awareness, well, that's not solving the problem. And then there was this article. I don't know if you're familiar with Dr. Murray Sabrin. Now, Dr. Sabrin has run for office a few times in New Jersey. He's a professor at Ramapo College. And he's been talking about the business of cancer. So I just wanted to have him on and have him give his two cents on this. Dr. Sabrin, morning, Murray. How are you? How you doing?
I'm doing great. How are you doing?
Good. So I saw this article that you sent out about Joe Biden talking about dedicating himself to fighting cancer for the next 15 months or 18 months that he's in office. Why did you send it out? What are your, give me your quick thoughts on this big business. You actually referred to it as big cancer, the way some people refer to big oil or big tobacco.
The thing is, this was a blog posted on LouRockwell.com, who's Lou has been one of the premier libertarian activists in this country for the past 40-some-odd years, and one of his bloggers put this article together about Biden and big cancer, and apparently, according to some people, are the primary reason that we get cancer. So the point is, you've got to educate yourself, and with the Internet today, people can educate themselves better than they have 30, 40 years ago when they had to just rely on their physician to tell them, this is the treatment you have to take, this is the medicine you have to take.
And right. I think now, although Murray, sometimes it's too much information. I think that's where some people get into trouble.
Well, this is why shows like yours, where you bring on people who challenge the conventional thinking about all these different subjects, is important, because we need to have an adult dialogue, civil dialogue on these issues, and bring people together to hash out the facts and discuss what is the best treatment that people should do.
Is there an article that I can tweet out based beyond this blog that talks about this 95% from the, you know, medicine's complicity with big business? Do you have something that you can send me that I can tweet out?
Well, the one that I sent out is the Biden and Big Cancer, Sustained National.
All right, and that has links to the book?
Absolutely.
All right, so if you're listening to this, all right, so I got to take a break, but Dr. Murray Sabrin, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5. Always interested in your perspective. You bet. We'll be talking soon, Murray. So he brings up a really interesting point that you know, things are changing in the medical community when you have doctors starting to talk about the prevention of cancer based on lifestyle. You're not going to eradicate all of it, but, you know, have we gone down this path that we are so over-reliant on pharmaceuticals? I mean, everybody's big now. Big pharma, big tobacco, big cancer. I've never heard that one, but that's new. I will tweet out. You can find me on Twitter at Bill Spadia, and the station is at NJ 101.5.